significant thing to do with the Wilburys was Jeff was there, George Harrison was there, you know, some days, and Roy Orbison was there some days, but it was all just, it was really Jeff Lynne that created that, because he, you know, he was the one that brought Roy in and wanted to make a record with Roy for years, and so when he finally did get Roy to come around, and Roy had moved to Los Angeles. Roy came over, we wrote some songs, Jeff and Roy and I. So we just take the same band and say, okay, well, today is Roy's day. And we cut a couple for Roy. And we did the same thing for Randy Newman and other people, you know. So it was just kind of one of those revolving sessions, you know, like, whose record is it today? But all the same people, Mike Campbell, this drummer named Phil Jones, and Jeff and myself, sometimes George. So the Wilburys started much later when George wanted to make an extra track for a 12-inch. And that day, you know, he asked us if we'd come help him, and we did. And we needed a studio right away. So Bob Dylan is an old friend of mine and George's. And we called Bob and we said, can we use your studio today? And he said, yeah. And so he got interested. And I think that was the beginning of it all, when the five of us were there and we wrote this song, Handle With Care. And then George took it to the record company, and the record company said, wait a minute, you know, this isn't a B-side. And so then I think you'd have to give George the credit for saying, well, why don't we start a band? And then he just came around to each of us. And so what do you think about starting a group? And fortunately, we all said yes.
Well, it's all
wonder what tomorrow will bring. Maybe a diamond ring.
Well, it's all right, even if they say you're wrong. Well, it's all right. Sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's all right, as long as you got somewhere to lay. Well, it's all right. Every day is judgment day.
Somewhere down the road away, you think of me and wonder where I am these days. Maybe somewhere down the road when somebody plays
the
purple haze.
Well, it's all right, even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right.
just glad to be here, happy to feel that. And it don't matter if you're by my side, I'm satisfied.
Well, it's all.
Traveling Wilburys album. It's got the title Volume 1, and I've heard rumors about a Volume 2 existing.
No, it's no, all rumors. There's no. That was, that's everything we did, you know. We don't even have an extra B-side, anything. That's every single thing the Wilburys did.
And will ever do?
Well, I don't know about that. It's too soon to say, really, if we'll do any more, because everybody's so busy right now. We still keep in touch, you know. We're pretty good pals, really, the Wilburys. We still, we often do more around the coffee table, you know. But I don't know if we'll ever do any more. I think the door remains open there, so we'll have to wait and see. It won't be this year.
Roy Orbison is the tragically dead Wilbury and tragically dead big artist in the rock pop era. How do you feel about the things you've been doing with him at a late stage in his career?
Well, I was very glad to have worked with Roy and to have known him, really. The last year of his life, we spent a lot of time together. We got to know each other really well, really. And, you know, I think it's sad, really. When one of your friends dies, it's tough, you know. It's tough to even think about it, really. He phoned me about 3 days before he died, and he was just going on about how happy he was about the Wilburys, you know. Ain't it great, you know, that sort of thing. And he died. So, you know, I think that's unfortunate, though I feel that somehow I felt that he knew, he could tell that things were going his way, you know, and I wish he could have seen it, you know, but maybe he did see it, you know, maybe he does see it, you know, maybe he's here now, I don't know. I've always felt Roy was okay, you know, from the moment I heard he was dead, I just always felt like Roy was okay, you know. He was a very bright man, a very intelligent man.
One word from you, I drift away. I pray that you are here to stay. Anything you want, you got it.
Try to replace him because you can't replace him. All the rumors about who's joining the Wilburys is just rumors. We had the Wilburys, I promise you, haven't picked anyone to replace anyone, you know. So maybe we will, maybe we won't. I don't think Roy would mind.